lovely guests from all of Robbo's adventures. Hong Kong is a real feast for the senses, and it just keeps on giving, as Robbo found out. Hello, David. What have you been getting up to?
Well, hello there, everyone, and welcome back to Hong Kong. Look, full disclosure, actually, I've got to tell you, we almost didn't make it here this morning because we are recovering from one hell of a party. It was with 40,000 of our closest friends as we celebrated the Ching Chow Bun Festival. We ate, we drank, we watched a parade that had over 2,000 people in it. And let me tell you, it was all leading up to the big finale. It's called a bun scramble. Now, it's probably not what you're thinking, so have a look at this.
To say that I'm having a great time in Hong Kong would probably be one of the biggest understatements in the history of the world. I love this place, but sometimes it's nice to get a little taste of home. And this place has one of the biggest Aussie expat communities around the globe. And one of those is making a big splash in the coffee scene.
Well, there are three things that Australians do very well. One, barbecue. Two, sinking a few tinnies. And three, making excellent coffee. And there are a few very talented expats bringing that beautiful Australian coffee to Hong Kong. And one of them is Scotty. Scotty, good morning to you. How are you, mate?
Good morning. Good, thank you.
Scotty's been brewing here for over 4 years and recently opened up his own espresso bar.
The city is so massive, over 7 million people, and you created this espresso bar here. Was that nerve-wracking?
I always believed it would work, an Australian-style espresso bar in this part of Hong Kong, where we are now, which is Soho, Central Hong Kong. And the main reason I believed it would be successful here is the heavy saturation of expats.
Fine Print is located in an area called Soho on Hong Kong Island. And let me tell you, for this temporary expat, it's well worth a visit. A local told me the best way to see Hong Kong was just to get out and explore, because you'll find something new around every corner. So today, I thought I'd jump on a boat. It's true. For the next year, Hong Kong is having one big celebration, the 20th anniversary of the handover. But there's another party that's been going on since the 18th century. So we headed to Cheung Chau to check it out.
On the 8th day of the 4th month of the Chinese calendar, the island of Cheung Chau comes alive with their annual bun festival. Now, on this day, 40,000 people will flock to the island for a celebration that lasts back to the 18th century, when it was used to ward off pirates. Well, the pirates have gone, and what remains is one hell of a party, which starts with a street parade like this, which has over 2,000 performers in it, and ends with an epic bun grab. This is Hong Kong culture on display, and it is spectacular.
The parade is a little unusual. There's plenty of noise and lion dancers leading the way. But the most important part are the children's floats, which seem to do just that. Children dressed as celebrities, sports people, or political figures appear to float through the streets. The big finale comes down to grabbing buns. The bun scramble will see competitors race up a 60-foot high tower of buns, grabbing as many as possible. The buns bring good luck, and the higher the baked good, the better it is.
Well, we are mere moments away from the big finale here at the Cheung Chau Bun Festival. It is the bun scramble, and to help us get ready, we've got four-time tower champion Angel. Do you like the taste of those buns?
Sure.
Do you ever get tempted to have a little bite of one on the way up?
These buns are made of plastic.
Oh, wow, whoa, whoa, that's a behind-the-scenes secret.
It's not edible.
Oh, we can't tell that, whoa, whoa. Well, good luck for tonight, Angel. Hopefully you'll make it number 5.
Yes, I'm sure.
Give me a bite.
Yes, good luck.
Finally, the moment we'd all been waiting for had arrived. It was time for the bun scramble. And Angel once again brought the buns home, making her a 5-time bun scramble champion. Hong Kong really is a place full of surprises.
Well, there is absolutely no denying that these people, they know how to party because you can hear them. They're still going. So it would be rude if I didn't join in. So I'll see you soon. All the best.
Oh, we're jealous. Thank you, Robbo. Now, if you want to experience all the things that Robbo was seeing, you can head to discoverhongkong.com/au. You can find all the information to book the ultimate Hong Kong getaway.